Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. I'm looking at a book on scrap quilting. It's called Stash Lab by Tanya Alexander, and it's published by That Patchwork Place, which is a division of Martingale. And when she wrote the book, Tanya started with this premise that all the projects in the book provide the opportunity to incorporate what you already have. They look at what you have with new perspective, and they offer you ideas for organizing and categorizing fabrics to give you focus and inspiration in your quilt making. Now those sound like good goals for the scrap quilts I like to create and for using up some of the scraps I have in my studio. And the book is actually divided into three sections. So one is on neutrals plus scraps equals balance. That's the premise of those projects. The second one is that value is greater than color, and that equals a strong design. And the third one is more equals better. So she lays out what she means by those three different sections in the book in more detail a little further on. So for example, the neutrals plus scraps equals balance. You're going to be taking a lot of your scraps, putting them into the quilt, but you're going to balance that off with a neutral, plain, solid fabric. And she gives you examples of them, of course, and several projects, so you can practice that premise. So one of the first ones is called Pixie Sticks, and it's a table runner. So it's 12.5 inches by 40 inches. So that gives you something smaller to start with. And she uses strip piecing for the creation of this project. And you're going to take those and mix them in with, they're going to make little sticks, little pixie sticks. And then you're going to mix them in with a gray solid in this particular example. So she goes through and shows you how to do all that. And it's something small to start off with. So that's a great project to start and to learn that premise. We go further into the book. She has another one, Kafe's Garden at Night, which of course is going to use some Kafe Facet fabrics. And I love Kafe Facet fabric. So if you do too, you want to take a look at this one. This is still in the neutrals plus scraps equals balance. And this particular one, it's like Dresden plate. And she's balancing it with a black solid. You could probably flip it and do it with a white. I'm sure it would look just as good. And she has also used a control colorway. Even though there's scrap fabrics in here, she's using some greens and purples in some of the Dresden plates. And then she's using kind of some oranges, pinks, reds, those kind of tones, the warmer tones in the other one. So there's a bit of control in this. You could probably use it with all different scraps and it'd look just as great. But that would be another section of the book, I think. The more is better, probably. Now, when I go to the next one, which is value is greater than color, and that gives you a strong design, the first one she has is called the Big Spin. And this is using all pinwheels. But what's interesting about this is that she's using that contrast idea. So you can see the darker fabrics in some of the pinwheels, and then the rest are very muted, much lighter. So you've got that contrast. And that's what makes some of these pinwheels stand out and the rest fade into the background. So they read more as just a solid background. Now when I'm moving ahead here, and this is called Brown Can Be Bright. The other thing that's interesting in this book you'll notice is that she doesn't have necessarily four borders on the quilts. So this one, for example, she has a border at the top and the bottom, but there's no side border. So that gives it a fresh look as well. This is in the more equals better section, and you can see that there's all kinds of fabrics being used in here. And it still comes out, looks quite homogeneous to me actually, even though you've got all different kinds of fabrics in there, but she's keeping to kind of a brown and blue colorway again. But then you can go into this one, which is called Carpool, and you can see there's more of what you think of as a scrap quilt, where you've got all different kinds of colors. You're not doing any kind of controlled scrap, where you're sticking to blues or browns or reds. She's got them all mixed in here, but she's using a solid to distinguish sort of sashing in here, and then she does have four borders on this particular quilt. So I found the projects in this book quite fresh and modern looking. I like the concepts that she's using. I think they'd be very good to apply to the scraps you have in your studio. So give Stash Lab by Tanya Alexander a try.